Hey, Whippers Nams, this is Tortum the Grey. Welcome back to another exciting episode of Minecraft Jurassic World Edition. I have done a little bit of work since last episode out here at the boardwalk, and not a ton, obviously. I mean, we've got the benches in, I think the trash cans and stuff were in and stuff like that. I just did decide that near the food truck, I needed a little seating area for some food. I'm not real sold on this umbrella, but I haven't come up with a better design for one yet, so it's still there. But yeah, just a little bit of work. We've got a bench over here now, which I think is new. Put a couple more plants around. You know, nothing real fancy, but I really am happy with what we did last episode. I really love this truck. And I think the seating area works out nicely. Used pretty much the same design as I've got in the food court over in the visitor center, so that works out. Just a little bit of an area there. And so today, we have got... Let's see, did I... No, I don't think I did any work down there since last episode. Although, we should run down there very quickly. Earlier today, I was prepping for this episode, I wasn't really prepping for the episode. I was doing that stuff on the boardwalk. But I happened to notice, I think I was flying over the lake with Casper or something, and I happen to notice something down here that makes me a little worried, and let's hopefully that was an isolated incident. It appears like it might have been, but I found this plesiosaur egg just chilling. It was just sitting right here, and as I flew over I saw it through the water just chilling there on the bottom of the seating area or the viewing area. I haven't really had any of my dinos breeding in a long time. I know Dozer and Dolly had made a little baby who's now hanging out at the Mesa at one point, but other than that, I haven't had any issues with dinos breeding, and I don't really want them breeding out of control. I know I can turn it off, but it's nice for me to be able to just pick up the eggs and things like that, as opposed to having to, you know, run DNA for everything, and so I haven't turned it off, and that'll probably bite me at some point, We got a random plesiosaur egg. It was just hanging out on the bottom of that. They must have, like, clipped into the thing when they were doing their baby thing or whatever. But, yeah. We've got a couple of dinos we need to name. And I think the best way to go about that, let's head to the back of the park first. We've got a couple of parasaurs we need to add names to. I wanted to ask you guys, though. The last time I was back here at the parasaur section, I was putting in the... Ooh, Casper's here. Perfect. I was putting in the employee access hatch on that enclosure, and I noticed the juvenile male was taking damage again, like Perry had and Neko had in the past. And I've never noticed that with another, they're just for no reason seem to be taking damage. And I don't know, several of you guys seem to be pretty knowledgeable in the mod, and I don't know if that's purely from just, you know, watching other people play it, or if you guys have, you know, extensively played these mods yourself or what. But if you guys, I mean, is there some a bug specific to the parasaurs, or am I just some weird thing that I've done in this enclosure that causes that? If you guys have any information on that, I would be thrilled to hear it, because it's just weird for me that they would be doing that. It was this dude. I threw some wheat down and they ate it. I don't know if that helps their health or what. Maybe I need to get some health potions brewed or something. But we've got Neko here. Right now I've got them sitting so they won't wander around and get themselves killed. But we do have some name tags for them. So here we go. Where's my list actually? Hold on one second here. I've got a list of who all suggested these names. All right, so the male parasaur is going to be named Swampy, and that was suggested by That Girl You Love. Sit your butt back down, Swampy. Nobody told you to get up. And then the female was named by Shane, and Shane suggested the name Pamela. Sit your butt back down, Pamela. All right, so we've got Pamela and Swampy and Neko now hanging out in the parasaur enclosure, so that looks nice. Made another little nest for them. I've got that in a couple of the herbivore enclosures. I don't know why. I kind of like it, but I don't know what purpose it serves. They don't lay eggs there. I was hoping that I could put an egg, I think when I originally constructed this, I was hoping I could put an egg down and have it not hatch. I was hoping I could rig that up somehow, but I don't think that's going to end up working out. But yeah, I'm really liking how this enclosure's coming along, and then I just have this, you know, rough employee access hatch here. so that we can get in and out of there without having to break the enclosure up, because we're professionals here at Jurassic Park. All right, so no real work been done out here. I still haven't even gotten around to continuing the fence around the brontosaurus. They're still just kind of chilling. Need to do that eventually, but as I've said in weeks past, we are working on the front of the park. So we are going to head back up there. We've got a couple of trikes to name as well. And then we've got a little bit of work we've got to do up here in order to get us back in a position, where we can, hopefully move on from this section of the park eventually. And so Park Casper there. Now let me head in here. We will quickly name our trikes. Let's see. Yeah, right here. Head on down. There we are. Alrighty. Okay, so we've got two nicknames. And, alright, so this first one is named Slag. And I'm crediting two people with this one. So, Eric Librado suggested the name Slug. And Josh, Stop Motion Action Figures and More, suggested a couple of names that Josh suggested Megatron and Optimus Prime, which are not names that I'm going to use on trikes, on Triceratops, because Megatron in the Beast Wars, when I was a kid, I watched the Beast Wars animated series, which was a Transformers 3D animation series where a bunch of Autobots, long story short, Megatron is a T-Rex, and well, we're gonna save that name for T-Rex, and Optimus Prime, I just felt like we could use that somewhere else, but, there was in the Dinobots, which is an off-branch of the Transformers, there was a Triceratops named Slag. So I'm crediting both Josh and Eric on this one, because Josh suggested Slug, and Slag is very close to Slug, and I was originally gonna do Slug until I caught wind of the Transformers connection, and I was like, well, okay, so Josh led me down a route that changed Slug to Slag, but you both get credit for it. So we're gonna name the dark green Jurassic Craft Triceratops Slag. So we have Trinity and Slag, and then we're going to name this little light green Fossils and Archaeology dude. Oh, they're so cute. Baby trikes are just so adorable. We're gonna name this dude Key. And so that name came to us from, where is it? Aurora North Star. Suggested we name one either Key Lime or Olive. And unfortunately, we'd already named the green Stegosaur, Eggsy's mate. Her name is Olive. And so I wasn't going to name another dinosaur in the park the same name, and Key Lime wasn't really a name, so I decided to go with Key. I don't really watch the show, but I know there's a pair of comedians that are pretty big right now called Key and Peele, and it is green like a lime and things like that, so it's a great name, but I just shortened it to Key as opposed to Key Lime, just because that feels like it could potentially be a name as opposed to Key Lime. So, there we go. All of our Triceratops are now hatched and named. Their enclosure is done. Well, I've got to do the lighting still. Gosh darn it. This enclosure is almost done. It'll be done eventually. But there we go. So four new dinos named. I think that makes every dino in the park. It has its own name at this point. So that's awesome. We'll have to start hatching some new stuff. I think eventually we might have to go on another DNA run. We might have to do a mining episode at some point soon. Because what I really want more than anything is to get Carlisle, our Carnotaurus, a mate. And we don't have any Carno DNA. The last couple times we've gone, out and looked for DNA, we still haven't gotten any Carno DNA. And so he is awesome and super lonely in here, and I would love to get him a mate. We probably will go out at some point soon, especially because, you know, the goal is to finish up the front of the park, so we're gonna be doing projects up here, but the front of the park can't be finished until all of our exhibits are populated, and, so, that's something that we need to, work on. Alright, so, as part of working on stuff today, we need to go ahead and get going on some of the stuff that I had scheduled. Alright, but we've got nighttime coming on. So before the baddies start spawning, let's go ahead and sleep. Very useful to carry around this bed now. Ooh, yeah, it's so much better than having to run up to the tower or just deal with bad guys. It works out very nicely. Alright, so we worked on the boardwalk last time, got it all set up. Now what I need to do, I mentioned to you guys that, in fact, let's go do that right now. I mentioned to you guys last time, so this is what, a 2x3? I can dig that. Yeah, and then what needs to be 1, 2, 3, 4 tall minimum. All right, perfect. I'm gonna be moving the ticket booth. And we're gonna be putting it right here inside this mountain. I don't like it there. I like this little kiosk that we built, but I don't think it fits well with this style so much. I've melded that style a little bit in the visitor center, but just, you know, next to this, it doesn't really work. And honestly, it's always, even, you know, ever since I put it up, it kind of has bothered me that it's in this line of sight, that it's blocking part of this archway's view. And so we are going to be moving that today, and I think it makes more sense because the park, if we look at the map, the park has always kind of, like, this loops in front of the entryway, and this is in front of the entryway, so it doesn't make a lot of sense for this to be the access point to the park. I think it makes more sense for us to put that up here and call that good, as opposed to, you know, I know the logical fallacy doesn't really come into play in any place but my mind, but it just makes more sense to put it here, and then it won't be disrupting, you know, that view or anything. So what we need to do is we need to get this place, and I want the silk touch. So let's go ahead, clear this out. So this will be we're gonna try and make it pretty much the same size. So it's 2D, ooh. This thing is hollow. Well, great. Fantastic. That's awesome. All right, well, we'll fill it in as best we can. Okay, so this is a... Yeah. We're good. All right, so we want this to be a 2 deep, 3 wide, 4... tall area. There we go. All right. So, and then in there, we're gonna want. Yeah, I don't know how much sprucing up of in there I really am going to be doing, but let's go ahead and grab the glass from up here, and we'll get it all in place. Now I wanna go ahead and take. Yeah, he can't get out of there this way, which is what I want. All right, so I think 5 will be all the glass we need. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alrighty, and then I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have to put an access point in here so I can get in there. But what I think we'll start with is let's put that guy down, and then we'll get our villager friend placed in here. Let's climb up here, get on top. There we go. Oop. Alrighty. And you, my friend. Actually, let's. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. Put this right there. What dinosaur was that? Some sort of trike or something. It sounded very close. All right, friend. It's time to... Is somebody out? Did somebody escape? That sounds terrifying. All right, buddy. I don't know. Don't know. All right, hang on. Let's do my axe out. And that, and then we'll put this there, and then we'll do one of those guys, and then we can do that. Perfect. Now that works out much nicer. All right, so let's take a quick look. I'm gonna grab our money slot gate thing there. Perfect. So yeah, this is, I think, the first week where No, this is the villager that I put in the food truck that I'm seeing on my map. Yeah, that's, where did that villager just go? Crikey. Okay, well, hold on. We can make this... Oh! It's Coco. That's what I was hearing. Why is Coco here? I don't know. It's like some dinosaur has escaped, because that is unnecessary. Coco, I had parked her up there. I'm not sure. They teleport at the weirdest times, it seems. All right, let me go ahead and collect this stuff up very quickly, because that guy is somewhere, and I'm not really sure where. But we will pop this portal down and go through, because that's odd, right? That's odd. He should have just gone through. Not sure what. Okay, is this my silk touch? Yeah. All right. Okay. Ooh, apparently my inventory is full. Oh, cause I got all these maps. Do I have a chest over somewhere here still? I actually think I just cleaned all this stuff up a minute ago. Okay. Okay. So I've got all the item frames. So let's quickly go in here. Okay. Oh no! Oh. Weird. I knew I'd lost one. I thought I placed it somewhere I couldn't find it, so I made another yellow portal, but I didn't think that I had left it here. That's odd. Okay. We've gotta get back to the front of the park. I think I started saying. So yeah, we're just doing some cleanup in the park today. This is the second episode of the week, and I said that if we started doing two episodes a week, they would probably start, you know, we would do, you know, some fun stuff. And, well, I mean, we're trying to make everything fun, I suppose, but, you know, we would take some episodes like, alright, so one episode, we're just gonna like, alright, we gotta get the Deinonychus enclosure going, or we gotta do some, you know, whatever. And so, I figured getting some of this stuff going, you guys wouldn't mind so much, and assuming I can get back... So I get back to the front of the park where everything despawns, it'll work out very well. But yeah, so it's Saturday. So basically, I said if double episodes ever come out, they'll be on Saturdays. I don't know, my schedule's getting kind of crazy, so I don't know that we can expect this to happen a lot, but this is one of the my favorite series and one of you guys' favorite series on the channel. Basically, this and Time Shot get the most views, and I have fun with all the series that I do, but for sure, Time Shot and Jurassic World are my, you know, biggest crowd pleasers, I guess. Oh gosh, why am I here? If and when we can get... Okay, good. So he's in there. Now I need to come in from another side so I don't just go through the portal, although there shouldn't be another one of those down anywhere, so we should be able to just do that. Alright, perfect. Now we have to be... Ooh, no, I switched those out, didn't I? Okay, we gotta be quick. So what I want to do is this, and gonna pop these in wherever for now, because I just need the inventory space. and I will come back and fix this at a later point. Okay, now I need to get back out of here. So I need this back on my bar so he doesn't follow me. What I need to do is put in a door to get in there, but for the time being, let's just get this kiosk picked up. There we go. Here we are. All right, that's better. I see that slab over there. We'll get to it. We'll get to it. All right, and so we got a couple of stone things we still need to pick for. Alrighty, here we are. But yeah, so we're gonna clean this out, and then if we've got time, which it looks like we probably won't, because yay, Tortimer's adventures and failure. What I want to do then, what we have to also clean up here at the front of the park, which I'll probably will at this point do off camera, because what I think we'll probably end up doing is instead of doing jumping over to that, what I'll probably want to do is let's get the front entrance all keyed in. So that we have that all good to go, because I don't want to just tear this apart and leave that standing. Okay, we don't have any dirt. Let's go put the rest of these maps where they belong, and we'll come back for that. And actually, yay, is it nighttime already? Man, time flies when you're having fun. All right, let's sleep very quickly. And then we'll get the rest of this going here. All right. Switch this out. Beautiful. All righty. And we should actually have a couple of sections of the map updating, which is kind of fun too. So that'll work out. Okay, so what I need is I need to recognize where each of these places are. Let's knock these out here very quickly. Ooh. He must be back behind us here. Okay, so this, I'm guessing, goes right there. Probably. That seems to make sense. I'm going to guess that this goes right here. Okay, that actually goes right there, would be my guess. This is the... Oh no, mate. You're probably in the wrong place. Okay, so let's see. This is desert and cold, so this is going to go... Don't want to hit you. I will. Oh, okay, great. This is the Carno enclosure? Maybe? What am I looking at? I guess it would be Carno enclosure, so we'll do that. This is just random nonsense. Random nonsense. There we go. This is the middle of the park, which goes right there. Compy enclosure goes right there. All right, so this... Where is the snow coming from on this one? I'm gonna say that this one goes right there. Does that look right? Don't think it is. Let's try that one. There we go. That fits. Oh, and then the extra snow obviously comes from the mammoth. Okay. Woo! We're getting it figured out. It'll be great. Okay. So, now, I think I will put in this flooring. So, let's do that real quick. Okay, and is there any chance that you're going to want to move? Where did this extra spruce come from? I have no idea. I have no idea. Okay, but so what we're going to do, let's get our smooth stone out. Let's get out of here. I'm going to seal him up. But before I do that, I'm actually going to right here. Put in a torch, and maybe right there as well. Maybe like, I really don't want him getting eaten by a zombie spawn or something. All right, so let's seal that up. Alrighty, and I'll put in a door eventually or whatever, but I think that works out for now, and I'll get a little fancier with him, but he's kind of in the way at the moment. But, so we've got these fences, And so if we take the fences, there we are. And we probably will want more, but if I put these here, I think that'll work. Okay, and then what I probably want is right in the middle. And we can put two gates on either side there. I think that'll work. Okay, so let's take this crafting bench, pop that down for now, and let's go ahead and turn this into wood. All right, if we get some sticks. We need sticks. It's been a while since I've built a gate. Oops, that's not what I want to do. There we go. All right, so I think it's this and this. Yes. So I want four of those, is the plan. Okay, we need more sticks. All right. Great, here we go. Perfect. So, we'll pop these down. Ooh, and they're not gonna catch up because those are carpenter fence posts and these are just regular fence gates. I do think there are carpenter fence gates. I'll have to look up the recipe for those. It's probably just the same thing but with carpenter blocks. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I don't think this episode ended up being entertaining. Maybe it did. I don't know. Let's check and see if that wall is still chilling here. It probably is not. Nah, it's gone. It's gone. Whatever. It was a couple of chunks of wall. But yeah, we got some work we got to do, and so I'll continue to do it off camera. But I think that is going to work out much better because I don't know if I've mentioned this or not. Ooh. Hey, creeper. Oh, baby, there we go. My goal is to make the front of the park kind of the access point. And I, you know, obviously can't control that. If we ever do the world download or whatever, you guys will spawn in the back of the park because that's just where the spawn of the server or of the map is. And I could change it, maybe. I don't know if you can, actually. But even if I could, I don't want to because I put my iron farm in the spawn chunks, and so I don't want to move those spawn chunks. But my ultimate goal is, and I guess it'll be on the list for when we, you know, are wrapping up the front of the park, but my ultimate goal is I want to build a tugboat back here, like a steam-powered tugboat that would just kind of be chilling here, and we'd have a dock or whatever, and then, you know, so guests would come in on the boat, and then they would come up through here, and I actually really, even now that it's in, I like the idea even more of having, like, the ticket booth here, kind of in this natural, you know, just terrain. And then we've got the gates there, and you come through the gates, and then welcome to Jurassic World. You don't have that kiosk there blocking things, and all that. So I think that's gonna end up working out nicely. I apologize for any of you guys who maybe liked the kiosk and don't agree with my move, but honestly, I think it'll be for the best. And we probably will definitely be using this kiosk design in other places. Just not there in the middle of this arch. I think it's much better that it's wide open, and you know, there'll be different things to see. Eventually, you know, we'll be building up on these mountains, you'll be able to see those. Eventually we may be doing, you know, some other things that would be in that viewpoint, but I just think it flows better to have it set up this way. But thank you guys so much for watching. I've been Torm of the Grain, you guys have been great. Next episode I haven't thought through yet, but it'll be fun, I'm sure. We'll do something more dinosaur-y. I'm building up to my 50th episode, so this was episode 46, so we've got a couple more episodes, three more episodes until our episode 50, so my goal is to have the front of the park done by episode 50. So I'll look at what we still need to accomplish up here before that happens, and I'll see what we need to do in episodes to get to that point. We may, if we don't have too much to do, one of the episodes in between now and then may be another mining episode, because I really do need DNA. And but I know for sure that like I'm probably going to be tearing down the copy enclosure on my own. But we'll have to see what else work lies. You know, we got to do the Deinonychus enclosure. And there are some aspects that the front of the park were not going to get done. Like the hotel, that's just not going to happen by episode 50. But I want to get like all of the existing projects up here. You know, we may have to take an episode to do the walkways. I don't know. But all of the existing projects and sections up here, I want to get completed. So, we'll make that work. I've got to finish up the museum in here, but that will probably be an off-camera project too. Some really saying again, good lord, I gotta let you guys go. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Torn for the Grade. You guys have been great. Make sure to those likes, comments, subscriptions for me, guys, and I'll see you all back here next time as we continue on the front of the park. We're getting close. We've got the plesiosaur stuff done. The boardwalk I'm pretty happy with. I'll probably continue to tinker with it as I tinker with everything all the time, but I definitely want to get some of this stuff more completed, especially like the pathways and stuff. We may do like a whole pathway episode because I'm not real happy with like the look of just the pathway in general. I like it, but it needs a little something. It needs a little bit of detailing. And then I need to figure out exactly how this bridge is going to work because we've got several bridges in the park. So I need to get that figured out and in place so that we can have that in place. So we have kind of a best practice to go from in the future. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I've been Torm the Great. You guys have been great. Make sure to those like, comment, subscriptions for me, guys. And I'll see you all back here next time. Alrighty, guys. Have a good one.